Hello, and welcome to your technique video for the kinetics of the reaction of crystal violet with sodium hydroxide lab. First off, the safety information. You will need to wear your goggles whenever chemicals are out. If you spill any of the solutions on your skin, wash the affected area thoroughly with water. Crystal violet is an organic dye that can stain clothing, so you might not want to wear your favorite shirt today. If you spill a large amount of crystal violet, you should wear gloves to clean it up. You will also need to bring a flash drive to the lab so that you can save your data and bring it home with you. During exercise 1, you will make a series of dilutions. Your lab manual lists a series of example concentrations to use, but you should use the volume that you actually delivered in your pipette to calculate the exact concentrations that you make. Do you remember the formula that we use for dilution calculations? That's right, M1 V1 equals M2 V2. Just remember that you should be finding M2 when you make your dilutions. Do not solve for V1 and then try to deliver this exact volume with your pipette. It's very hard to do this. Instead, use the volume that you ended up delivering to make the dilution as V1 and solve for M2, your dilution concentration, after you have made the dilution. You will make a set of serial dilutions. Your TA will expect you to know how to do this before you come to lab. If you do not remember how to make a set of serial dilutions, you should go watch the clips from the 116 Physical Properties and Copper Amine labs to refresh yourself. Follow the instructions in your lab manual and make your serial dilutions. You should now have your stock and 4 dilutions. You will then get 5 cuvettes. Make sure they're clean. Then fill each of them up about 3/4 of the way with each of the solutions. Now, just a disclaimer. If you were in an advanced lab course that was more concerned with collecting extremely precise data, you would definitely not want to use separate cuvettes each time. Because imperfections in the structure of the cuvette can cause error in the measurement, you would want to have the same error each time, right? So we'd use the same cuvette on each trial. However, since we have to swap rooms to take our measurements, we are going to use 5 separate cuvettes this time. After your cuvettes are ready, you will go to the UV vis spectrophotometer to collect the absorbance of each of the solutions at 560 nanometers. The sodium hydroxide solution will be your blank. Record your data in a table in your notebook. So you will know what was happening in the spectrophotometer, you will add 1 drop of the stock crystal violet solution to a test tube containing 7 milliliters of 0.2 molar sodium hydroxide solution so that you can observe the reaction before you have to record any quantitative data. Record your observations in your notebook. Now it's time to collect our kinetics data. You should get 2 cuvettes. Fill 1 3/4 of the way full with 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide, and fill the other cuvette 3/4 of the way full with 0.2 molar sodium hydroxide. Now it is time to move to the UV vis spectroscopy room. Take some of the crystal violet stock solution with you in a small beaker with 2 pipettes. You might want to bring along an extra 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide cuvette in case you have trouble moving quickly enough the first time you try this. This week, we will be using the Kinetics program on the spectrophotometer. Select Setup and set your wavelength to 560 nanometers. Hit OK. You will use the sodium hydroxide solution as your blank to zero it before starting the experiment. It should say Load Sample, blank. Press OK. Then press Start. You will name your file and press OK on the Load Sample again. A countdown for 2 minutes will now begin. Quickly take the cuvette out of the spectrophotometer. Add 1 drop of crystal violet to the sodium hydroxide in the cuvette. Use your other pipette to suck up the contents of the cuvette, then squeeze everything back into the cuvette. This mixes the solutions. Put the cuvette back in the spectrophotometer. Close the cover and immediately hit OK on the computer to start collecting data. If you don't move fast enough, some of the blue color will have already faded and your data will be less conclusive. If you weren't able to perform this quickly enough the first time, do it again with your extra cuvette to collect better data. You will save your data as a .csv file and take it home with you. Finally, you will do the same thing with your 0.2 molar sodium hydroxide cuvette. Make sure you save off your data and take it with you. All of the solutions used today can be disposed of in the sink. Thank you for watching this video, and I will see you next week.